What do we all have in common with Olivia Munn? So much, including our mutual love for live television. We're going to talk about the shirt you're wearing and why that's important. Yeah. About a year ago, we talked about the Critics' Choice Awards. Yeah. We were doing the red carpet show, and then you were hosting the show, and you were saying what you enjoyed about it most was that it was live.
That it's live, you know, like that was a big undertaking.
I know.
That was such a fun, it was such a big room, you know, and the Critics' Choice Awards is such a prestigious award, and to have all of, you know, those people in the room that I, you know, love and look up to. It was a lot, but the fact that it was live, it's like that I could just, you know, like I was saying that there, Niecy Nash and I did a Toast to the Good Guys, and I had this Mark Wahlberg joke at the end because all that stuff had gone on with the movie with him and Michelle Williams and him getting, you know, paid so much for the reshoots. And I didn't tell anybody I was going to do it, so I just threw it in at the end, so no one really knew. But I knew that if it's live, you can't
undo it.
You can't make me.
And did you get a laugh, too?
Yeah, that was a good, and then the next day he donated a large sum of money to like the movement.
Go.
So, but it was one of those things where when you're live, you know, people get so nervous. So then everyone's so careful. They don't want to, you know, like, let's just not. So, but it's live, it's too late. Mm-hmm. But that's when I started on G4.
Right.
And I love doing this daily live show. Mm-hmm. And it's just so much fun.
Speaking of daily shows, they tape it, but it has a very live feel. You were involved in the 12 Days of Giving with Ellen. How was
that?
How crazy is that audience?
It is. You give people amazing free things. Like, they go crazy. It was, I've always, when I would watch shows and growing up, I'd always be like, gosh, I wish I was in that audience.
Right,
like,
right.
Because they get, we gave, on my day, we gave a 6-day trip in Mexico.
That's amazing.
Wow, to everybody.
Everybody
there.
Yes.
Nice.
My goodness.
I know. She gives away really
good
stuff.
Yeah.
I can get you guys tickets.
All right.
The hookup. The shirt you're wearing is about dog rescue and helping dogs. And it says here that you fell for a rescue dog just by seeing the back of the dog's head.
That is true. So, I rescued my first dog, Chance, when I was, my publicist created, helped create this show called Cause for Paws, which is all about rescue animals. Mm-hmm. And so then I met Chance there, and I wasn't looking to, you know, put on more responsibility. But then I just fell in love with him and took him into my life. And then about a year and a half or so after I had him, I could tell that on set he was super depressed. Like, he'd be with me, but he needed another constant. That's little Frankie. Look how cute that is.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I went on to the Lovelio Rescue Instagram, and I saw the back of Frankie's head, and I was like, that's my dog. And I didn't even see that. I go, that's my dog. And then I flew out, and I was filming in Atlanta, and it was actually sweet because I flew out, and Kate McKinnon was doing reshoots for Ghostbusters. So then, and Frankie was so small. He was found in downtown LA on the streets. And so Kate, like the people from Ghostbusters, they sent her a private plane to do her reshoot. So she let me jump on it from it. She was doing a movie with me in Atlanta.
Oh, wow.
So we literally just, she went with me to LA, and then we came back with little Frankie on this. Like, it was like the most, I was like, your life is very different
now.
And by the way, it's never been like
Cinderella.
That again.
Right.
I'm like, this is the only time we'll be flying private with Kate McKinnon.
What's going on with Wags and Walks?
Well, Wags and Walks is a really great shelter. And right now, so WAG is this, it's an app for dog walkers. It's like the Uber for dog walkers.
Oh, I've seen that at events and things, yes.
So WAG, I'm an investor and also the creative strategist in WAG. And we're in so many cities, and we're looking to branch internationally as well. And the whole purpose of WAG is making things better for your pets and for the owners. You know, a lot of times especially we're in LA, we're so far away, we can't get back in time.
And you're kind of stressed out if they don't get regular walks and things like that.
And so we have this really great system in place, and it's been super successful, and so many people have loved it. And it was really important for me when I was involved with them to do things to help other animals. You know, mm-hmm. it's, you know, you have a business, you're making money, but now when you start making money and you're doing well, we have to give back. I mean, that's the only way to do it. And so we have WAG for Good, and we are partnering with different shelters, and we create these boxes because during the holidays, it's when a lot of, you know, animals get like thrown off to the side and go into shelters. So we have these boxes that we bring to all these different shelters and across the country to, you know, help make the pets happier and healthier, and just try to do what we can.
If you want to learn more about everything Olivia's talking about, the Wags and Walks series of events, you can download the app. The information is there. WAG. Nice to see you this morning.
Yeah, nice to see
you
guys.
Thanks, Olivia.
Thank you so much.